Like the Nazarenes at the beginning of the century, the Pre-Raphaelites are young and united in their rejection of the modern world. Like the Nazarenes, they believe that the source of a better art, a better life, lies in a return to the clear forms and haunting legends of medieval Europe. They retreat to a time when the world was young, peopled with gallant knights and gentle ladies and charmed castles and cursed forests. Founded in 1841 by Dante Gabriel Rossetti, the group includes the painters Millet and Holman Hunt. Soon they are joined by William Morris, the great author, designer, and radical, and the painter Edward Burne-Jones. Their subject matter is religious or mystical, and invariably medieval in feeling. But the settings for these rich mixtures of symbol, allegory, and myth were the landscapes of England. But this is an England seen with a mystical and visionary intensity. Every sapling and butterfly and rainbow lovingly and glowingly rendered. Their paintings have about them a dreamlike precision. Burne-Jones writes to his father about a walk in Oxford as though he had stepped into a medieval tapestry.
The day has gone down magnificently. All by the river's side, I came back in a delirium of joy. The land was so enchanted with bright colors, blue and purple in the sky, shot over with a dust of golden shower, and in the water, a mirrored counterpart ruffled by a light west wind. And in my mind, pictures of the old days, the abbey and long croziers, gay knights and ladies by the riverbank, hawking parties and all the pageantry of the golden age. And then the sound of earthly bells in the distance. And presently the wreathing of steam upon the trees where the railway runs called me back to the years I cannot convince myself of living in.
From this kind of mix of observation and fantasy, reality and make-believe, the Pre-Raphaelites compose their haunting vision of the Golden Age.
The curtain has been lifted, and we had a glimpse into a twilight world of dark, mysterious woodlands, haunted streams, meads of dark green starred with burning flowers, veiled in a dim, mystic light, and stained with low-toned crimson and gold.
This is perhaps the last fling of the Romantics yearning for a somewhere else before the soot-caked, machine-powered reality takes over.